So, Debbie, you're with Hikari Animal Shelter out of Hood River. Tell us a little bit, you know, give us a little bit of an idea of what you guys do.
Well, basically, the Hikari Shelter was actually bequested to us by Ross and Daphne Hikari, and they built the shelter. The Hood River County Sheriff's Department built the shelter.
Oh.
And then 6 months later, a gal named Susan Kent formed Hood River Adopt a Dog.
Okay.
And we actually manage the shelter. So it's a combined effort with the sheriff, the county sheriff's department, and Hood River Adopt a Dog.
Awesome. So you guys, last week we talked to
Home at Last.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. Yep. Home at Last out of the Dells. And so do you guys duplicate services? Or are you just like the Hood River area?
Yeah, we're for the Hood River area. And all of our dogs, actually, we do not have what's called owner surrender. Our shelter is pretty small, and we don't have enough volunteers at this time. And so our dogs actually come in via animal control, the
okay.
sheriff's department.
Oh,
they're
okay.
either lost or stray or abandoned. And
okay.
what happens is they're under the property of the sheriff's department, and then we they are in a holding pattern for 3 to 5 days, hoping that an owner comes forth. And then if not, they are handed over basically to Hood River Adopt a Dog, and then they go up for adoption, and we are allowed to place the dogs.
Okay.
So, you know, it is similar in the sense that Hal receives dogs in any way they come in, and they do place them for long-term care. We don't do cats, whereas Hal does. We are just doing dogs at this time, again, because of the space, and we're just small. We're only 2 years old. We are very, you know, we're growing, we're new, we're learning, and just really providing, like, the Parkdale, Odell, and Hood River areas.
Okay, okay. Awesome. Well, that's great,
so
because obviously this is a service that needs, you know, to extend not only beyond beyond the gorge, but to all of the communities of the gorge. So we have with us
Zoe,
and Zoe is...
Well, I'll give you some background on Zoe. She came to us at the shelter approximately in January of this year. She's been with us for a little while, and there are reasons. Well, actually, she is a great dog.
Yeah.
She is a lover. She loves kids. She's playful. She's happy. However, she needs to go to a home that doesn't already have dogs. She doesn't get along with all dogs. Some she does, most she doesn't. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, with her, she needs to go to a loving home. But when she goes out, she needs to be on leash. We don't want her running around the neighborhoods and things like that. So we're
sure.
looking for a home that can, you know, accommodate her needs that way. But she is a lover. She's a great dog. She's loyal. And she's really just really happy and fun. Her breed, we thought, was something called an American Staffordshire Terrier. And what we did a DNA test on her, and she came back with a variety of breeds. Primarily a bulldog, secondary an Italian greyhound.
Really?
There is also some Rottweiler.
No way!
Some golden retriever, and a Doberman. So she has a long heritage, I guess.
My goodness. I would have thought that she was, you know, had a, you know, probably primarily pit bull.
No, and that's a lot of confusion. There's a variety of dogs that have pit-looking characteristics. They're not necessarily pit bulls. So, you know, that's probably another one of the hurdles she has, is people
yeah.
look at her and say, wow, that's not, you know, the type of dog I want. But yet
right.
she is not. So.
Yeah, get scared off because they think it's a pit bull. And
yeah.
that's, you know, pit bulls kind of have a reputation. But
yeah, they do. She's a lover,
I mean,
lover.
She was walking around the studio earlier, and she just seems so docile, actually, and
mm-hmm.
just really, really...
Yeah, she lays around the house.
Easy to get along with.
Yeah, she really is. She's a great little gal. And she's about 2 years old.
Okay.
She has had a litter. She came to us via the animal control.
Uh-huh.
It seemed that she was owned, but the owner did not come forth, so we took her into the adoption program. And she had a litter, like I said. She has been spay, and she's had all of her shots. And so we don't know much about her other than she is from the area. She was found in the Odell area, and she's approximately 2 years old.
Now you say found. What do you mean found?
Well, the animal, you know, the animal control officers, the dogs come in either, like, maybe they've been reported running around the neighborhood, or someone has seen a dog that, you know, has been running around the neighborhood and has kind of homeless and doesn't seem to be that there's an owner. And so the animal control officers, they do rotations around town, and they pick up strays, basically.
Okay.
And,
and she was part of that?
She was part of that, yep. We get a lot of owned dogs that are just lost dogs.
Really?
And that's why we put them in a holding pattern for 3 to 5 days, hoping that the owner is going to come forth. And
well.
Sometimes they do, and sometimes they don't.
Well, we certainly want to help her get a home. So if you are at all interested in finding or having as your next best friend, we certainly would love to hear from you. And how should they contact you?
There's on our website, hoodriveradoptadog.org. Our phone number and address are there. We also have adoption days on Wednesdays from 5 to 7 and Saturdays from 9 to 11. They can just come to the shelter in Odell and take a look at all the dogs that we have.
So if Zoe doesn't quite fit what you're looking for, you certainly can find what you're looking for at the Hikari shelter. And Debbie, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And
well, thank you for doing what you do each week for the dogs. We really appreciate it.
Yep. And next week we'll meet another.
Great. Thank you.